What's up, the world? It is your friendly neighborhood Slipgator here, and I have steak. I have steak. I have steak. I have steak. So, yeah, we've got some stuff done since yesterday. You know, I've been putting these videos out every single day for over 3 weeks now, and I think we've got a lot done on Fortress. So a couple things I haven't heard anybody comment on that I have questions about. Should I raise these towers up one more story? I think that I should leave them at this story, get some nether wart, and put a fire in the top of each tower. I don't think I should raise them up, because if you raise them up and put the fire in the top, you're not going to be able to see it. So, but I could just raise them up about to there, because it would look epic. So I had that question, leave a comment. I also want to thank the Ultimate Striker 1 for subscribing. Thank you very much, I appreciate it. I was fooling around with some lighting options here, and I don't know why, I just thought this kind of looked cool. I put some up in here too, where I just put, these are trapdoors, underneath the torches. And I kind of did it over here, and I thought it kind of added just kind of a little bit of quality to the wall, as opposed to that, and it's kind of more plain, but I don't really know. I don't really know if I like it, so I wanted to ask you guys, leave a comment. This is going to be the leave a comment episode. Ready? Oh. So good. Little bread. Little sandwich. So, I've been busy making cows hump. So there's all sorts of, yeah. I know, dude. This is Salty. So guys, meet Salty. What's up, Salty? Salty appeared in my house. Bessie the cow. Albion just appeared on the bridge. Bessie just appeared. And then Salty just recently appeared. So we don't have another cow yet. But hopefully soon, another cow, another pig. Hopefully soon we'll have another pig, a little buddy for Salty to hump. But we got all sorts of little bebes hanging out, and I'm going to make steak out of them and put them in my belly. I can get a lot of steak. I have a looting 3 on this sword, so if I kill them with a sword, I've had them drop to 4 steaks. Oh, and I didn't even show you guys this, and it's almost gone. I don't think I showed you this. I got a breaking 3 efficiency for 14-3 on a single pick, which is pretty badass. Also, I just got efficiency 5 on breaking 3 on another pick. JVapes28 suggested that we put an arched walkway above these two towers and connect them. I don't think it's a bad idea. I think it's hard to do arches with blocks with that few. That space is so small that it won't really look like an arch. It'll kind of look like. So I don't know. Everything looks like that. It's Minecraft. But I may still try to do it. I kind of put something up real quick, and I didn't think it looked super awesome. But I thank you for the suggestion, and I may try to work it in and make it look a little bit better. We widened out the walkway over here a little bit. I started working on the spider spawner down there. I want to make it automated, have on-off lighting, redstone lamps, and I want to have a lava blade in there so I can harvest string from them. So this is the other lighting option that I've done, and I don't know if I want to do this around the entire wall because it is lighting intense, or it is resource intense. But what is this? Alright guys, I said I was going to make a brewing room, and I made a brewing room, so check it out. Thought it was pretty badass. Got some cauldrons here. Got all my brewing shite. Some bottles and magma cream and spider eye. I gotta get some sugar over here and stuff like that. Also just keep kind of like a random chest full of stuff. We have cauldrons, ultimate or unlimited water source up top. So we can get water whenever we need it. And there's that. So let's go ahead and show you. Where's the stairway? There it is. Show you guys the wiring for some of this stuff. This was really not super easy because the biggest problem that I'm finding with redstone, the biggest problem that I make, is that I try to do stuff really compact and I don't leave myself enough space. So like up here, the lighting where these pistons come down, this all fits inside of the wall here. So it's only like 2x3 space for wiring, which isn't that big when you're wiring up redstone. And I also had to use a T flip-flop here. So I built this T flip-flop down here underneath and then wired it up. So this is my input from the button coming around here, and then the output to this torch up to that torch. And then that flows in over here to these pistons. So I am absolutely and completely positive that it is not the most efficient design ever. I'm sure there are easier ways to possibly do it, but part of learning Minecraft is kind of doing it yourself. So I did it myself. The T flip-flop I looked up and just found a simple tutorial online about it. I looked up a couple of different ones. The first one I checked out didn't work, and it was a smaller T flip-flop, but that one did work. I really like that. And the timing is totally random. Like, I didn't actually time that out. It just happens to be that that's how it works because of some repeaters I had to put in. But one of the things in here is that I did have to put some lighting on some redstone glowstone up top, because right around here I was getting a light level of around 6. But these are lights. So check it out. It is a glowstone behind a trapdoor. And again, I know maybe I've done may have been done before, but I think it kind of looks kind of cool. But I want to know what you guys think. I thought it looked a little different for this room, and I really don't think that it's something I could do to the entire... I just left these open, too, because I thought they kind of looked neat. I don't know. I can't decide. Just tell me what you guys think about lighting and stuff like that, what you think about those different changes. I don't think that I would be able to do this lighting, even though I'd like to. I mean, I just couldn't do it around the entire wall of Fortress. It would take me, like, 2 or 3 days of just like nethering, and that's it. I'd just be in the nether all the time. And I don't like the nether, it scares me. But everything still works over here with the gate, which is good. So, pardon me. Yes, we have not tackled the wheat. I put a couple of signs up here because I was thinking about digging this down a little bit, and I was thinking about making a second level above and a third level below. But really what I think I'm going to do is tear this entire thing to pieces and sculpt some things and kind of make a road through here instead. I think that this is a monstrous, ugly, super disgusting ugliness that is ugly. I don't like the way it looks, I don't like the way it fits, I think it takes up a lot of room, and I think really what needs to happen is it needs to be moved underground. So, I did a lot more mining, just because I just really like it, like, I just really think it's fun. I have over 2 stacks of diamond now, and hollowed out a little bit more of this room here. So what we're gonna do in here, we're gonna make the transportation hub here. This is the grotto. We may do a little bit more sculpting. I'd like to perhaps, because the caves that are up here, they come around into this area as well. Like I had said before, the cave system here is extensive. Ridiculous. The biggest cave system I've ever seen. I've only played probably 5-6 seeds maybe. Maybe 10, but still, these caves are unbelievable. But I think about expanding the grotto out into this area as well, just to kind of make it a little bit prettier. And what we're going to build in here is the transportation hub. There's going to be a four selector minecart station here. It's going to take us to the mine. It's going to take us to the Falcon's Boot. It's going to take us to the Ambry, which is the storage area, and it's going to take us to the house. So it'll have all four of those, and then it'll return. You'll be able to return all of the carts back. Everything will start from the same spot. I am going to be using a design that I saw on Zazuma Void's channel, and I think his design is based off of Ethos or something that Doc M did. All of those Rockstar Minecrafters. But it is going to be pretty cool. But what I've decided to do from now on, after I was building up the the cauldron room, after I started, pardon me, after I got to build up the cauldron room, and a couple other redstone projects that I've done, there will no longer be a lack of space when I do redstone projects. I understand now that there needs to be a compactness of sorts, but at the same time, fitting in wiring in a super tight spot is really a pain in the ass. And it has its place, and it's kind of fun to do, and it was rewarding. The cauldron was rewarding. The potions room. But, yeah. So now I'm going to take you over to my test world, and we're going to talk about the minecart station. I'll show you what I got built so far. This is what a two-selector version of this looks like. So you can see why it is that I was hauling out such a large space in there, because I'm going to need to fit four of this in here. But the basic principle is... You have your buttons here and a nice little redstone indicator. You know, it kind of tells you where you're going. That way you can put a sign up, in each place, and then you hit your button. What that does back here is changes the selector and moves this rail. So if I hit this one, you can see that now this rail goes in this direction off. So if I put a minecart on here and I send it down, it's going to go off of the first line, like so. Pardon me. So now if you hit the second selector, what it should do, or what it does do, is it moves this track to the other position, which basically makes it so that the minecart goes straight past, and then it moves this track to the correct position, like so. So there you can see that this one has moved back this direction, so if a minecart comes from here, it's just going to go past, and then this track is moved to go in that direction. So if we put a minecart on here, it will go past the first line and then take the second one. So we're going to have to build this and expand it. Pardon me, I'm stuck. Why am I stuck? Is there a reason why I'm stuck? We're going to have to expand it, build four. So it's going to be pretty large, and I'm also going to utilize the design that DocM has for the kind of like your launch pad area, which is some soul sand with a piston activation system that puts you on a powered rail. And I do believe what I'll end up doing is I will take and set up the return area, and I'm not sure exactly how to do the return system, but I'll set up a return system so that you can take everything back to the grotto, so that way you can get to the Falcon's Boot spawner, to my house, to the Ambry, and to mining from one central location, and then from any of those locations you can get back to that one central location on the grotto. So yeah, that's the design. That's what we're going to be working on tomorrow. So let's go back and hang out in Sliptopia. Maybe we just go down and do a little bit of mining and just chit-chat. So we'll head down here. I have started to slowly but surely put some finishing touches on stuff. You may notice that I've done some actual work on stuff like lighting. But a lot of my areas are just really ghetto because right now they're just functional. You know, that's what I'm doing. I'm just learning the game. There's a slime back there. I'm just learning the game. These areas are just functional. That's what they're for. And I really don't mind it. You know, I think a lot of times I see a lot of areas that are like, there'll be a guy's mine and it's so refined and beautiful, and that's cool. I mean, I guess it's cool, but for me right now, whoa, we got some major bad hombres around here somewhere. I looked for these guys the other day, and I could not find them. They're like right here. Look at that. 34. They look like they're right here, and no matter what I do, I can't find them. Let's go on a little journey, shall we? What the hell? Oh. But I can hear them. They're like right here. Oh, found them. Oh, shit. That was unfortunate. All right, let's just calm down for a second. Oh yeah? Well, this is pretty interesting. I mean, I spent countless hours. Oh, F. This should do the trick. Countless hours trying to light these caves up. I can't really even explain to you how long it's been. Where I just hang out. Thank God I have the sword. Oh, wow. So, this is cool. Alright, you're trapped back there. Let's see if we can get him in the foot. Nope. Alright. What up, Skelly? So, this is a whole new mine system. Not mine system. A whole new cave system that I haven't seen before. I haven't got a chance to explore. Let's see kind of what we got here. Alright, this is pretty straightforward. Looks like I've been there. Unless that's some naturally occurring obsidian. A lot of times those obsidian pieces are from me exploring. Like so? Oh, come on. So, let's go ahead and just harvest some of this crap. Oh, wait, is this like... No, I haven't been here yet. Just make sure we don't hit any lava here. Lava? Nope. Alright, that's good. Take some of this. Watch this with this Fortune 3 pick. Watch this lapis explode. That was 8. That was considerably more. Yeah. If lapis is what you're looking for, grabbing the Fortune 3 pick is where it's at. But I even have 2 more of the Fortune 3 picks. I really would rather have like efficiency and unbreaking together, which is good because that's what I got. But I've seemed to have been getting more fortune than anything else. So, kind of show you how I mine. So this is a dead end area, basically. So because this is a dead end, there's nothing here that I want. Block it off like so. And then, well, I like it being a little bit more neat. Place 2 torches. The 2 torches signify that is an area that I have already seen and I do not need to go and see it again. So that's good to go there. Now, this is how I came in. Let me just go ahead and mark this. And we'll put a bunch of torches right there, and that kind of signifies that this is the way out. Normally I just do like an assload of torches means way out. Because I want to explore this area. A lot of times these caves are great. You guys know how it is. Caves are great for resources. Plus I want to lower my total entity count, so I want to, light up whatever I can around here so that my total entity count goes down. Is this a, no. So yeah, so I'm excited. We're head through here, maybe do some exploring, and see what we can find. Some water down. Oh well, that was exciting, wasn't it? So at the very least, we did get some stuff lit up, which is what we want. And we'll quiet down this water. So that's cool. I've been walking by this damn cave for 3 weeks now listening for it and hearing it. And let me see. Oh, no, we're not done. like a little girl. Burn, fucker. Give me your iron. Oh, maybe it's bigger. That's what she said. I smell skeletons. Yeah? You got nothing. God, you suck. Oh no, it's one of those. It's just gonna get bigger and bigger. That's what she said. Alright, so let's come back here. I talked about it before, but I always put down floor torches when I'm going through a caving area. So if I'm going through an area, I put down torches on the floor, and that signifies that if I follow those back, that's the way out. How many torches I got? 21? I don't have any wood on me. I can't make any more. That's cool. We'll just go with it. Alright, so let's see what we got going on up here. I hear a lot of bad guys. I see iron? No. There's iron. Oh man. Oh man. I was hoping, I was kind of excited when I saw that the cave wasn't that big. Where's my other floor torch? I was kind of excited when I saw it wasn't that big of a cave. But it looks like that it is that big of a cave. Just my luck. Come on, zombie. Come on, fucker. Yeah, maybe if you'd have been smarter and came at me, you might have had a chance. Iron? Yep. And coal. No. Yes. Oh, we're way low on torches. I need some wood. God. And we'll start doing, instead of lighting these up, in order to save torches, I'm just gonna fill them in. What? Seriously? Oh my gosh. Try to use my torches more effectively. Oh, nice. Alright, that's good. It's good that they went that far. So, I'm gonna pick these up on the way back, but I want to keep this place lit up. Yeah, so I'm gonna have to leave some. It's a light level right here. 9, 10, 9. Looks all good down through here. Take that. Yeah, this all looks like it's pretty well lit up. Take this. What do we got here? 10, 9, 10. Yeah, not bad, not bad. Oh, spider. God. What? Is there more? Oh yeah, okay. So, what do I got? Let me see if I can get this blocked off. Oh, F. Oh, that's a spider spawner. I'm gonna take a guess and say it's a spider spawner. Hmm. Maybe not. Maybe just 3 spiders. Or it could be a spider spawner. I really need sticks. I always have like so many torches on me. I'm so surprised I don't have any. That's where a knockback comes in handy. This place is cool. Wow, there's a bunch of badass guys in here. Come on. More back there. I'm just surprised by the sheer number of baddies in here. Oh, that sucked it. Only 4 torches left. Is this like some sort of kick-ass ravine? Oh, yeah, it is. Oh, what a neat place. Oh, cool. Oh, God. Oh, no. It's so big. I have so much to do. Slime. I didn't see slime. Is that a cow? Oh, okay. Well, we're out of torches. I got 2 left. I'm gonna have to go back. So for now, that's gonna be it, guys. I'm gonna go back, get some more sticks, get some more torches. Been talking to you for a while. I think it's time for this episode to end. But as always, thanks very much to any new subscribers. Please leave a comment about the stuff we talked about so that I know what you guys like and that sort of stuff. Stay cool, world.